Welcome back to Midday Kentucky, everyone. I'm over here at Creative Kitchen and Bath trying to find out what are the latest trends when it comes to kitchen and bath designs. And of course, I'm here with Deborah, one of the lead designers over here. How are you, my friend?
I'm wonderful this morning.
How did you ever get into talking about kitchens and bathrooms?
Well, I love design, first of all.
Okay.
I'm a degree designer from in interior design from UK. I've been in the business for 30 years. I am an allied member of ASID, which is American Society of Interior Designers. I'm a certified kitchen designer and certified bath designer.
When people come and see you, what is their main concern? What's the fear factor of having a change out in a kitchen, for example?
Well, it's just the stress of going through a home remodeling.
And that's why we need you.
It's for, it's a big part of it.
Exactly. All right, so let's start off with kitchens, everyone. Talking about what you're seeing coming through as the latest designs and what can people expect to see.
Okay. And this has been happening for the past couple of years, just very clean, modern design. Very simple, classic lines, lots of white cabinets, neutral colors, grays, warm beiges, lots of just really beautiful classic design.
And I love the subway tiles in a kitchen.
Again, it's a classic. You cannot go wrong with it. We add the touch of personality in a kitchen, in a punch of color, lots of different backsplash tiles. But if you're afraid of color and pattern in a kitchen, a subway tile is a great way to do
it. And I'm noticing that the stoves are looking a lot more industrial now.
Yes, yes. Even it used to be you could only get that look in a very high-end $10,000 range. Now all the manufacturers are offering lower cost options that do look more commercial.
And do you feel that having a colorful backsplash really works in a kitchen, or do you like the still very natural?
Well, that's all up to the personality of the homeowner.
Yeah.
And that's how we infuse their wish list in the kitchen.
Okay, I've always been told not to do aluminium cooktops. Am I right?
Cooktops or countertops?
Well, countertops, I call them. Yeah.
No, we're doing lots of stainless steel. Again, it's one of those products that is going to scratch. It probably won't get to the job without scratching.
Okay.
But it's wonderful. I mean, that's why you see it in commercial kitchens.
But how do you keep the darn thing clean?
Oh, it's just easy. You just wipe it down with any kind of cleaner.
Okay, because do you remember when they've had all those fridges that come out, mm-hmm. and they say, don't buy an aluminium fridge, it will always look dirty. Agree?
Yes, and they do. You have to clean them. It is a downside of a stainless steel. There is a little more maintenance to it, but that's what people want.
Now, what some of the images that we're looking at, we've got one of the cabinetries that is more of on the brown side.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Is there a difference in pricing when it comes to color? Or is it more of the design?
It's more the cabinet line itself. There's, always a good, better, best. And, they're all the woods are very similar prices. Walnuts are going to be a lot more expensive than a maple or oak.
How do you feel when you see a fridge put behind one of the cabinetry doors and hidden?
It.
It's a beautiful look,
isn't
it?
It's a gorgeous look. Again, it's all up to the homeowner and what their wish list
well,
is.
Well, Deborah, you've given us some good advice. If you want to find out more information about Creative Kitchen and Bath, or maybe you want to hire Deborah to come and take care of your brand new kitchen for you.
Absolutely.
All the information's up on the screen. We appreciate you, my friend. Coming back after the break, everyone, you're watching Midday Kentucky.